Okay, do you wanna know one of the hardest things that I found when I was first learning to code? Well, specifically learning React, I should say, was search functionality. And I think it's because searching through an API or a list, it seems so simple in theory, similar to a to-do list, but in reality, it can get complex pretty quickly. And it's one of those things though that when you actually do take the time to really understand how it works and go through the process of building it, it's one of those things that will stick with you, and it really helps solidify a lot of the fundamentals. So today we are going to be building a React app going through search functionality of a really fun API. Also too, I want to include, I feel like I've done a few of these Code With Me videos and we don't talk about Git very much. So we're going to speak about that in this video as well. And of course, another thing similar to Git in the sense of we don't talk about it a lot, but it's so important, is documentation. I'm going to be sharing with you a tool that a lot of your employers will be looking for if you have skills around or have used in the past. And let's just dive into it. Okay, let's go. Okay, so as you can see on screen here, we are going to get into the React app in a second, but as I mentioned earlier, I really want to focus on other parts of the development process. You know, a lot of these Code With Me's are around code, which makes sense, but there is so much other tools and things that you need to be aware of as a developer or someone interested in coding. So you can see up on screen here, I've been using Swimm, and essentially Swimm is a dev tool that reinvented the way developers manage knowledge about code. What do I mean with that? Well, here are three points that really helped me understand Swimm. One is it's easy to find. So if you have ever used any documentation working for a company before or writing your own documentation, a lot of times it can get messy really quickly and difficult to find. Think of when you're onboarding at a new company, how difficult it can be. Another thing about it is it's always up to date. Developers don't need to worry about, is my documentation up to date? Documentation should be something that is almost like a third arm, if that makes sense, meaning it just functions. It's just part of what we do versus it's this thing that we have to struggle with all the time. Okay, so you can see on screen here, I have Swimm. I did add a repository as I was working around with it, and we are going to add a new repository for this video. So I'm gonna exit out of Swimm for now. We'll get back into it and let's create a React app. Okay, so let's just start right from the beginning. That's what I feel like a lot of tutorials typically miss is, okay, where are we gonna go inside? Let's go inside documents. And now we just create our typical React app, npx. Sorry, my keyboard's over here if it looks weird. This is the problem with working with monitors. Well, not really, it's supposed to solve that problem, but create React app and let's call this React Search App. All right, and now we wait. I think it's time to go get a coffee. Okay, now that we have our project up and, well, not running yet, let's actually do that. So now that we have our project open, I should say, let's go ahead and run it. So npm start, just to make sure the React app is working. It came up on a different page here. There we go, we have our standard React app. And as I mentioned in this project, we are going to be focusing on search functionality. And I thought I would do the fun celebrity API. So actually, while I'm speaking of the celebrity API, let's go to it right now. API Ninja. All right, so I found this resource a while ago. It's really cool, it's called API Ninja. And essentially, there's just a lot of fun APIs. So I made an account, you don't have to put in a credit card or anything. And I went down to, there we go, Celebrity. And this is the API we will be using. So as you can see here in Celebrity, provides a lot of different parameters that are optional, name, net worth. Obviously you need to get an API key, which you can do from my account, your account, but the button's called my account, just to be clear. And you can see here some sample requests. So it's very user friendly. So we are going to be using this for this project. Okay, now let's stop this from running for a minute here. And the reason being, a lot of this video, as I mentioned, I want to focus around Git as well and documentation. So let's create, do Git init to create a new repository. Reinitialized. Oh, I already had this repository. Okay, if you don't, do get in it and it will create this. Now, if I go into, let's go here, we can see we have this .git file in our React search app. Okay, I got ahead of myself and some of it was not recording, but what did I do? I did git add to add all the files. Then I did git commit message, which was just React App Starter. Don't come at me, I know some of you are very particular with your messages to start with. And then before I did a push, I just wanted to see the git status, so you can see that here. And I did git push. So now it will send us, if we click on this link down below, it will send us to the commit we just made. And you can see all of our files are here, which is great. Okay, before we get any further into this project, I mean, we're just starting out, but let's add Swim to this so we can easily document as we go along. Okay, now what we can simply do, I'm in Swim, in the Swim app, and I'm going to go to repositories down to the bottom and add new repository. So for here, you can see all your repositories. I already connected my GitHub to Swim, is why I can see all these. That's a step one you will need to do, but that's extremely straightforward when you sign up. It will just kind of walk you through those steps. Then here, let's go down to our React search app, connect, have a little coffee break. Okay, perfect. So now you can see we are connected. Now, as of right now, we don't have any docs or playlists. So let's get started. So you can see here in Get Started, we can create a blank doc, playlist, PR, templates, for example. This is a great one if you want a flow in the code or how to add something, internal API. Like, you can start by with a template, which I sometimes find really helpful. Otherwise, it's just overwhelming as to starting with a blank page. So let's use this template, a flow in the code. And let's retitle this to React Search App. And then this document describes the, not necessarily flow in our system, but I really liked this template. So this describes the React application that is building out search functionality. Perfect. Select the first step where the flow begins, the entry point or API call. Okay, we will come back to this as next step. Let's actually integrate and use this API. Okay. All right, let's get into the code now. Let's go source and let's go into our app.js. So for this, let's simply, as of right now, let's take out all of this and just have an empty div here. And really the first thing I want to do is start, let's start using this API. First, let's create search term and let's also go set search term and
Okay, now we can see if we search for a Nepo baby. Let's do past searches here. Gwyneth. 150 million. That's insane. Okay, let's do Kate Hudson. See, it's really cool though. I like how we built it that the results will continue to filter as you are searching. So something starts with a T or has T in it, I should say. Larry, etc. So this is really cool. This is simple functionality, but it allows you to take a very important part of React and coding and have this skill, be able to do it and build onto it. Now, let's get to the fun part. First of all, let's go back to our project here. I'm gonna stop running this for a second. And the next thing I'm going to do is look at my status, so get status. So you can see here, we have modified, I have my terminal. Perfect. So next let's go git add, and then let's go git status. Go up a bit more since I can't see anything. We do not want our environment file to be included.
Okay, so now the most important part where so many of us are not either experienced or we forget until it's way too late is the documentation. In my documentation, let's go ahead and you can see here, if you do slash, you can see a bunch of different commands. So from paths, images, docs, playlists, mentions. Mention is huge, especially if you have other teammates. But I wanna focus on code snippet to show you how it can update in real time. So first of all, this is amazing. You click on it and it will open up your repository to the latest changes. So you can see here where all of our changes were. So say we wanted to focus on our fetch specifically. So let's go here, snippet selected. And at this point we can add more code. Add, let's go add. This is what I wanna focus in on. And it looks so pretty. So for this snippet, I want to focus on telling where you can find your API key.
You can retrieve your unique API key from API Ninja. API Ninja, do capital. It will be located in the My Account tab. Insert this API key in your environment. Perfect. And there we go. How nice is this? And then also too, look at this copy anchor link. So say you want to send it to someone specifically, and you can see it's up to date as well.
Okay, let's keep on going down a little bit here. And okay, I'm gonna delete this text here. It says falling with all this stupid camera. Why did we do this? Why? Okay, we're gonna put you down a little bit because you're really in my way here. All right, so now let's keep on typing away. Actually, before we do that, I wanna share with you how quickly these code snippets update. So, as I mentioned, we have here, we can see what code is utilized and highlighted, but if we go back to repositories, say we go to React Search App, Source, and obviously you can do this in VS Code, but let me just show you here how quick it is. So we go Edit. Let's go down and say we wanted to make, I mean, even something simply like change text. So net worth from 2023. Just change some text, but this could be changing big things in your code base, etc. Next, let's go commit changes. All right, now we go back into our documentation and let's just refresh it. Can see here from 2023. So these changes are happening almost instantaneously, which is, you can see how useful this would be, especially when you're working in collaboration, in teams. I mean, even in this instance, it's so useful for us to be able to have some documentation about the project we are building and where to find our API keys, etc. Now let's commit these draft changes. You can see here in the top right hand corner, docs successfully closed. Oh. Doc successfully committed. I cannot speak today. So let's go back here. And you can see now we have a dot swim, which is all of our docs. Name, file version, app version, introduction. And it's so
Like, it looks so pretty. The code is so nice. You can imagine with hundreds, or maybe not hundreds, I hope we don't have hundreds of documentation, but with tons of documentation, how beautiful this could really get. And we also have a JSON version of this, just to have information about the ID of the repo, and also if it's configured with Swim, which it is. Okay, let's do one more flow though. So let's say here, let's go back into our code snippet. Say we want to document around the search results and why we are returning what we are returning and how others can get other data from that. So let's go add and scroll down. We can see it's up to date here. But say we make some changes here again. So let's go back into our VS Code. So we can see here now in our Git repo that we have added the new P tag and the result max height. And if I go back and swim, you can see here auto-synced snippet. You can see that it's out of date. So we have, this was of course the old auto-synced by swim, and then the new here. Do we want to accept it or reselect it? And of course we want to accept it. So that's another great thing. You can always be up to date with your code, and it really highlights any changes that are made throughout the document. Now I can also go commit one change, and as simple as that, because we added this code snippet in and we haven't committed it yet.
Okay, another thing I want to share with you is about smart tokens. So essentially what they allow you to do is you can type in your backtick and then type in your token reference. So this could be a variable, a class, and Swim will actually suggest content from multiple repositories. So you can see here my two repositories. Now I feel like this isn't the best example of that. Rather, I'm going to share with you on screen here an example where they are doing the front and back end repositories. This is a really great example of when you maybe want to utilize or reference something from a different repository, especially when you're working on large teams with multiple repositories, working on the front end, back end, and want to understand everything. Also too, one thing I love about Swim is you can actually integrate them into your IDE. And you can see here, I have Swim on screen and I need to connect my repository, but I'll actually show you a diagram that they have of what you can really do with Swim. So you can see here, docs sit next to your code, which is beyond handy. I can't even tell you. I mean, you know. And also too, there's advanced markdown editors. You can actually be editing the docs right within your IDE. So you can essentially just stay working in VS Code or whatever IDE you are working in, and you don't have to go back and forth, which, as we know, if we do have to go back and forth, we oftentimes just neglect the documentation. All right, so I linked Swim down below, so make sure to go play around with it, check it out. This not only I think is good for those of you who are, many of you who are working on a team at a large company, of course this is beyond useful for that, but I think it's also useful if you are someone who is just starting out in your career or earlier on. It really will set you apart having this documentation included in your code, showing that you actually understand documentation, you care about it, and you're using this really advanced tool to build the most beautiful and functional documentation. All right, it is, if you see outside right now, it is snowing like no tomorrow. So I feel like it's end of the workday for me. I need to go to relax. Let me know what you think of Swim. I linked it down below again. I'll see you all soon.